worship Jesus. Te adoramos, Señor. Oh, te adoramos, Señor. Oh, te glorificamos, Señor. Tú amas. Oh, you dance, Lord. You dance, oh. Deep, Lord, how con poder, me guarda con poder, me guarda con poder, Él está sobre mí, me guarda con poder, Cristo me guarda con poder, Él está sobre mí, me guarda con poder, me guarda con poder, me guarda con poder, Él está sobre mí, me guarda con poder, Cristo me guarda con poder. All over me, He's keeping me alive, He's keeping me alive, He's keeping me alive, He is all over me, He's keeping me alive, Jesus is keeping me alive.
God bless you all, everyone that's watching us. Hope you believe that God blessed you with these songs that were sang. Dios le bendiga a todos los que nos están escuchando. Le pedimos que Dios lo haya bendecido con las canciones y los himnos que oyeron. Y nos poderoso. Tenemos un poquito de problema tecnológico, pero lo vamos a arreglar todo. I want to let you know that today we are going to preach to you a message called Rise Church Rise. Le vamos a predicarle un mensaje llamado Levántate Iglesia, Levántate. It's Palm Sunday, it's Domingo de Palma, but this is going to be a different kind of message, and I'm going to let my wife say a few words to you and just welcome you all to this amazing time we're going to have today.
Buenos días, Iglesia. Good morning, church. And we're here in all the nations, and we miss you very much. Le extrañamos mucho, y estamos orando que el Señor nos ayude. Trusting the Lord that He will help us come back together. We miss you so much, but today we're going to hear the word and we're going to be edified. Hoy vamos a edificarnos con su palabra. I love you all and I miss you. And listen, get your Bibles and we're going to just listen to the word and what the Lord has to say. His voice is the one that counts. Su voz es la única que cuenta en este momento. God bless you.
Amen and amen. We're going to have pastor. It's going to come up. Pastor Max is going to take a few minutes and just encourage you. Va a tomar unos minutos para darle ánimo a ustedes.
Good morning, church. I miss you all so very much. I don't see you, but you are right here in our heart, in my heart. So this morning, I was reflecting, and God pointed me to a passage in Habakkuk, and that was when he was questioning God, not questioning God to challenge him, but questioning God to give him understanding and encouragement. And I hope that this few passage or scripture would encourage you to know that the Lord is in the midst of our problem. God's hands is not shortened that He cannot rescue. His eyes are not blinded that He could not see. His ears are not heavy that He could not hear the cry of our prayer. And Lord God is always with us. We can count on His enduring and never failing presence. So here's Habakkuk in chapter 3. It says, Lord, I have heard of your fame. I stand in awe of your deeds, O Lord. Renew them in our day, in our time. Make them known in wrath. Remember mercy. Anyone don't talk about plague, pestilence, and God is still in the midst. And in verse 17 it says, though the fig tree does not bud, and there are no grapes on the vine, though the olive crops fails, and the field produce no food, though there are no sheep in the pen and no cattle in the stall, yet I'll rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in God my Savior. The sovereign Lord is my strength. Let me make it personal. The sovereign God is our strength. is the strength of the nation, the strength of the world. And he will make my feet like the feet of a deer. He enables me to go on the heights. And this prayer was in a time of struggle. And the theme is that the righteous will live by faith, that we must feel that God is right here with us. And that if we feel that we are being judged, remember that God and his judgment and his mercy always walk hand in hand. So this morning, the stock market may really flatten out. The bank account, the unemployment checks, whatsoever it is, there's an overcrowding of the hospital. The health system is overwhelmed. But guess what? The Lord is with us. And the only way that we will have this virus dealt with, not only on the medical side, but also in the spiritual side, is to sing our recovery and our restoration away. So be encouraged and sing in this time, and let faith arise. For the Bible says in Habakkuk that the righteous will live by faith. God bless you, and have a wonderful moment as Pastor brings you the word. Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor. God bless you all again. Dios le bendiga todo. I'm going to preach a message. Voy a predicar un mensaje de. It probably has nothing to do with Palm Sunday. No tiene que ver nada con la Pascua. But it's a prophetic word. Es una palabra profética for these days, para estos días. I mean, God has been speaking to my life. Dios ha estado hablando a mi vida. In spite of the fact, encima de la realidad, that I am, that this gift que te don is in clay vessels. Está en vaso de barro and de. Yes, we all make mistakes. We all sin. We all fall short of the glory of God. Todos hacemos errores. Todos caemos de la gracia de Dios. Every one of us that is listening and everyone that is hearing me, todo el mundo que me está escuchando, quiero que tú sepas que we are imperfect beings used by a perfect God. Que somos gente imperfecta usada por un Dios perfecto. And I believe, y yo creo, that in a time like this, en el tiempo como este, we need a message that's not only going to encourage us, no solamente el mensaje nos va a traer ánimo, but the message has to correct us. El mensaje tiene que también corregirnos. We are in a time that the enemy, estamos un tiempo cuando el enemigo, and you may not believe this, puede que tú no creas esto, but this is work of the devil himself, esto trabajo satánico mismo. To try to bring down the church, tratar de cerrar nuestras iglesias. Worldwide, en todo el mundo, the churches are closed. Las iglesias están cerradas. But stores are open. Tiendas están abiertas. There is liquor stores are open. Hay tiendas donde venden bebidas están abiertas. There are other places. There are abortion clinics that are open. La clínica de aborto están abiertas. And yet the church is not open. La iglesia no está abierta. And I can understand that we have to protect each other. Yo entiendo que tenemos que protegernos uno a los otros. But if you saw recently in Florida, Pastor Ronnie Brown was arrested. El pastor Ronnie Brown fue arrestado because he gave a service in his church. Porque dio servicio en su iglesia. And I believe that we are in a time, yo creo que estamos en un tiempo, that the enemy, if the church doesn't wake up, si la iglesia no se despierta, and starts praying, empieza a orar, and seek God's face, y buscar la cara de Dios, if we don't do that, si nosotros no hacemos eso, we are going to be facing a greater enemy, vamos a enfrentarnos un enemigo más grande todavía, when this is all over, cuando esto se termine. Why? Because the longer this takes, mientras más tiempo esto coge, the longer the people stay away from church, mientras más la gente se van fuera de la iglesia, and they're not communing with God, no están teniendo comunión con Dios, and reading their word, leyendo su palabra, and seeking God, y buscando a Dios, the more the enemy is going to work in your mind. Remember, the battle is in your mind. Más el enemigo va a trabajar en tu mente. Recuérdate que la batalla está en tu mente. The battle is in your mind. La batalla está en tu mente. So I want to read this text. Most of you know this story. La mayoría de ustedes conocen esta historia. And it's the story of David, es la historia de David. As he comes into the camp of Israel, mientras entra en el campamento de Israel, and you all know the story about David and the giant, saben la historia de David el gigante, but I need you to see it from a different perspective. Quiero que usted la vea de una perspectiva diferente. A perspective, una perspectiva that God wants you to see it, que Dios quiere verla. Now, I'm going to read that first, 1 Samuel 17:26. Vamos a leer 1 Samuel capítulo 17, versículo 26. And I'm going to read it in Spanish, lo voy a leer en español. And thank you for all the people who have written, todas las personas que han escrito. I mean, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people have been writing and sending us emails and letting us know that they're listening. Cientos de personas nos están mandando emails y dejándonos saber que nos están escuchando. But they also told us that they like the Spanish and the English. Me gusta el español e inglés. So we're going to keep that format no matter what we do. Vamos a mantener ese formato, no importa lo que hagamos. Amen. So let's read it in Spanish. Vamos a leerlo en español. Dice, entonces habló David a los que estaban junto a él diciendo, ¿qué harán al hombre que venza a este filisteo y quite el oprobio de Israel? Porque ¿quién es este filisteo incircunciso para provocar a los escuadrones del Dios viviente? The word says in 1 Samuel 17:26, then David spoke to the man who stood by him, saying, what shall be done for the man who kills this Philistine that takes away the reproach from Israel? For who is the uncircumcised Philistine, that he should defy the armies of the living God? Now let's just I want to bring you this story. Quiero traer esta historia so that you can see it, para que tú la puedas ver. For the longest of time, and I mean, it was not months, and it was not 2 weeks or 4 weeks like we've been spending home. No fueron cuatro semanas como hemos estado en la casa. Fue por mucho tiempo. This Philistine, este filisteo called Goliath, llamado Goliath, would come out every day, salía todos los días, and defy the armies of Israel. Y venía y le decía al pueblo de Israel, le hablaba como si no tenían valor ninguno. He would talk to them as they had no value whatsoever. Now, I need you to see this because this is important for today. Esto es importante para el día de hoy. Because the Bible says, la Biblia dice, that Israel was hiding, estaba escondido. Israel was afraid, Israel tenía miedo. Israel would be trembling at the sound of the voice of this giant. Israel temblaba al oír la voz de este gigante. Now, I need you to know, yo quiero que tú sepas, that this story is not in the Bible, esta historia no está en la Biblia, just so that you entertain yourself, para que tú te entretenga. I need you to understand that every word in the Bible, cada palabra en la Biblia, is just as viable, vale tanto then like today, como hoy. Therefore, the Bible is the same today, yesterday, and forever. La Biblia no cambia. The Bible is to edify our lives. La Biblia para edificar nuestra vida. Every day this giant came out. Now, I want you to understand that every day, todos los días, este gigante salía. And we see every day in the news, todos los días en la noticia, that things are getting worse and worse and worse. Que las cosas se están poniendo peor, peor y peor. Every morning you get up, a la mañana tú te levantas, 1,000 more died, 1,000 más murieron. There's another 10,000 more with the virus, hay 10,000 más con el virus. And every day, this giant, este gigante comes out, sale. Every morning, every evening, every night, toda la mañana, a la mediodía y a la noche, este gigante sale. This giant comes out like a defying giant, como un gigante defendiendo y diciéndole al pueblo que ellos tienen que temblar, que deben tener miedo y temor. Every time this giant comes out, he's defying not only the world, he's defying the church. Listen, church, I need you to understand, the devil is not worried about the world. The devil is worried about the church. If he can bring fear to the church, si puede traer temor a la iglesia, if he can bring fear to you, si puede traer miedo a ti, if he can have you at home trembling, si te puede tener en la casa temblando, and not doing nothing, no haciendo nada, just afraid, teniendo miedo, what's going to happen? ¿Qué va a pasar? Will there be enough food? ¿Habrá suficiente comida? Will my kids survive? ¿Mis hijos sobrevivirán? Are my kids going to make it? Will there be hope for the next generation? ¿Habrá esperanza para la próxima generación? Can I tell you if the devil got you like that? Si el Satanás te tiene así, you're going to be in trouble. Vas a tener problemas. You're going to have a hard time coming out of it. Vas a tener un tiempo difícil saliendo de él. This giant, este gigante that gets up every day
rey que se levanta todos los días. Define your faith. Oh, este gigante que siempre está en contra de tu fe. Está siempre tratando de que tu fe caiga. Trying to make your faith fall. You need to get up in the name of Jesus. Tú tienes que levantarte en el nombre de Jesús. And you need to start believing God. Y tú tienes que empezar a creerle a Dios. This enemy, este enemigo, is not your enemy. No es tu enemigo. This enemy, este enemigo, that has gotten up every day, que se levanta todos los días, and has us shaking, y nos tiene temblando, and it has us wondering, nos tiene preguntando, when are we going to get back to the house of God? ¿Cuándo volveremos a la casa de Dios? Well, let me tell you, church, you need to rise. And again, I say, rise, church, rise. Levántate, iglesia, levántate. Come on, church, rise. Rise right there where you're at. Get up right there where you're at. Lift up your hands up and say, we will rise. We will not let this giant, no dejaremos que este gigante no derrote, will defeat us. No weapon formed against us can prosper. Ninguna guerra formada con nosotros prosperará. You need to get up right now in the name of Jesus. Somebody needs to get up right now in the name of Jesus. Alguien necesita levantarse ahora en el nombre de Jesús and believe God y creerle a Dios. Believe the word of God. Creer la palabra a Dios. Listen, all of Israel was shaking. Todo Israel estaba temblando. The entire Israel, nobody knew what they were going to do. Nadie sabía lo que iban a hacer. There was mass confusion. Había una confusión masiva. The king was scared. El rey tenía temor. He was hiding. Él estaba escondido in his palace, en su palacio. The head of Israel, la cabeza de Israel, hiding, escondiéndose from the enemy. I will tell every pastor that's listening, todo pastor que está escuchando, every evangelist, cada evangelista, every missionary, cada misionero, every leader, cada líder, every deacon, cada diácono, every trustee, cada ujiel. Let me tell you, you need to get up in the name of Jesus. Tú tienes que levantarte en el nombre de Jesús. You need to start believing. Tienes que empezar a creer the word of the Lord, la palabra de Dios. Get out from where you're at. Sal donde tú estás. This is not a time to hide. Esto no es un tiempo para escondernos. This is a time to rise. Esto es un tiempo para levantarnos. This is a time to rise. Esto es un tiempo para levantarnos. This is a time to rise. Esto es un tiempo para que la iglesia se levante. Listen, pastor, fear not. No tenga miedo, pastor. No tenga miedo, líder. Don't fear. This giant is about to come down. Este gigante está para caer. But if he can make you think he's going to be here for a long time, si él te puede hacer creer que va a estar por mucho tiempo, you will stop praying. Tú vas a dejar de orar. Now listen to me, because it's important that you understand. David came into the scene. Can we have a David today? David represents the church. David representa la iglesia. David came in. And why do I tell you that David represents the church? ¿Por qué yo te digo que David representa la iglesia? Because David was a worshiper. Porque David es un adorador. David knew how to worship in the middle of the trials, in the middle of the problems. David sabía adorar en medio de los problemas, en medio de la tribulación. David knew how to get up. David sabía cómo levantarse. And defy the wolf, and defy the lion, and defy the bear. Él se iba en contra del león, del oso. No importa if anybody got near his sheep. Si alguien se iba junto a sus ovejas, he would defy him. He would with his own hands tear that bear apart, tear that lion apart. He didn't just sit around and no se sentaba and watch the bear and the lion destroy his sheep. Verlo destruir su oveja. No. The Bible says, la Biblia dice, that David, que David would get up and say, you will not take one single one of my sheep. Tú no tomarás ni una oveja mía. You need to get up like David. Tú necesitas levantarte como David and say, you will not take one of my children. You will not take one of my grandchildren. And yes, my children will have future. Tú no tomarás ni uno de mis hijos. Tú no tomarás uno de mis nietos. Te digo, Satanás, que tú no tienes poder en contra de de mi familia. You don't have no power against my family. I don't know if there's a David out there right now. No sé si hay un David que se pueda levantar. I need you to look at your kids right now. Mira a tus hijos. Look at your husband. Look at your wife. Mira a tu esposa. Tu esposa. Tell them. We will not let that devil steal another day from us. No lo dejaremos que se robe otro día de nosotros. Este Satanás es un mentiroso. Listen, David comes into the camp. David entra al campamento. And let me tell you something. Oh, my God. Oh, my Lord. When David enters in, the giant was 5 times his size. El gigante era 5 veces el tamaño de él. And always the problem looks way bigger than you look. Siempre el problema se ve más grande que tú pareces. Always the problem will look like it's bigger than it is. El gigante siempre se ve, el problema se ve siempre mayor que lo que tú te ves. Hear me, church. I need you to listen to me. I don't know if somebody's out there listening to me and could just say, hey, 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 hey. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm believing God. I'm trusting God. Watch this, because watch this. The giant was prowling around going fee-fi-fo. I'm going to beat somebody up. I'm going to tear somebody up. El gigante salió esta mañana. That morning, the giant came out and he said, I'm going to destroy somebody. Voy a destruir a alguien, dijo el gigante. No habrá alguien. Is there not somebody from the people of God, del pueblo de Dios, who has the anointing and the spirit of God that can get up? And he said, is there anybody amongst God's people that can beat me? Habrá alguien que pueda conmigo? Oh my God, I need you to understand that greater is he who is in you than he that is in the world. Que mayor es el que está dentro de ti que está en el mundo. Now watch this. This is powerful, right? Because David walks into the camp. David entra en el campamento. And he's watching the scenery. Y está mirando esta escena. Y cuando mira esta escena, when he looks at the scenery, he's going like, something is wrong in this picture. Hay algo mal en este retrato. Something, how many of you know there's something wrong in the picture you're seeing every time in the news? Hay algo mal en el retrato que está viendo en la noticia. And you notice that, dale cuenta, that all the doctors, the Dr. Fauci that comes up, el Dr. Fauci que se levanta, he's supposed to be the hero of the nation. Él es el héroe de la nación. And every time he goes up, he has bad news. Cada vez que se levanta, tiene mala noticia. It's going to get worse. Va a ser malo. It's going to get worse. We're going to be this time. Yesterday he said, we're going to be like this until September. Dijo que tendremos así hasta septiembre. And I tell you one thing, I like what the president said. Me gusta lo que el presidente dijo. He said, no way we're going to be there. We are going to get over this quick. Esto se va a terminar pronto. We're going to finish this soon. The nation is going back. La nación volverá a trabajar. But hear me. Because he doesn't know God like you know God. Él no conoce a Dios como tú conoces a Dios. When David walks in, cuando David entra, and he sees the scenery, and he's looking at it, y lo está mirando, he says, I know something is wrong in this picture. I go mal en este retrato. Now you stop looking at things like the world looks at it. Deja de mirar las cosas como el mundo la mira. You need to start having the eyes of Christ, la ojo de Cristo, the mind of Christ, la mente de Cristo. May I tell you, God did not bring this disease. Dios no trajo esto. He didn't bring this virus. Él no trajo este virus. God does not bring anything bad. The word says that God is a good God. La Biblia dice que Dios es un Dios bueno. He's a good God. If anybody tells you that God brought this because he's testing the church, he's a liar. Si alguien te dijo que Dios trajo esto para probar la iglesia, es un mentiroso. Because God is a good God. Dios es un Dios bueno. Now, will God use this for his purpose? ¿Usará Dios esto para el propósito de él? Of course God does. God uses every bad thing for good, for his goodness. Para su Dios usa todo lo malo para lo bien de él. Watch this. As David walks into the camp, David entra al campamento, the Bible says that he's standing next to the guys who are trembling. Está sentado, parado al lado de los que están temblando. Now this is a beautiful scenery. The people next to him, la gente al lado de él, they were trembling. Estaban temblando. They were scared. Estaban asustados. And just suddenly, David looks, David mira, and here comes this giant. And he's walking in the camp. And he's walking in the camp. And you know he's walking in your camp. He right now he's scaring you. Right now he's scaring you. Ahora mismo te está asustando. Right now you're going, ahora mismo tú estás diciendo, oh, I don't know. Oh, pastor, I know. I know what you're saying, but I'm scared. Sé lo que está diciendo, pero tengo miedo. You need somebody in your house. There's got to be somebody in your house. Tiene que haber alguien en tu casa who will stand up like David, que se pare como David, and say in the name of Jesus, y decirle en el nombre de Jesús, I bind all spirit of fear in this house. Ato todo espíritu de temor en esta casa. Is there somebody out there? Habrá alguien allá afuera right now, ahora mismo, who will get up in the name of Jesus y se levanta en el nombre de Jesús and say, I bind the spirit of fear in the name of Jesus. Who is this coronavirus? ¿Quién es este virus corona? Who does she think she is? ¿Quién se cree ella quién es? Does she understand? ¿Entiende ella that we are the church? Nosotros somos la iglesia. The gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. La puerta del infierno no prevalecerán contra la iglesia. Is there somebody out there who knows who they are? Habrá alguien que conoce quién son? Because I tell you, David stood next to the people who were fearing. David se paró a los que tenían miedo. And he just looks at them, lo mira a ellos y dice, what is going on? ¿Qué está pasando? Who's this guy? ¿Quién es este hombre? Who is this piece of junk? ¿Qué es esta porquería que está al frente de mí? ¿Quién es esta gigante que no vale nada? Who's this giant that is not worth anything? Who is he? And everybody started saying, oh, you don't know. Oh, that guy comes out. He's been coming out for a long time. He's been coming. Este no, tú no lo conoces. Este gigante está saliendo todos los días. Si tú lo conocieras, tú estuvieras temblando como nosotros. And yet, that's it. That's the calls you get. Esa es la llamada que tú recibes from people all over the place, de gente donde quiera. Oh, you better be careful. Be careful. You could be next. You could die next. Tú puedes morir. Tú no sabes si tú eres el que vas a morir. Now I'm here to tell you something. Yo estoy diciéndote algo. You will not die. Tú no vas a morir. You will not die. Tú no vas a morir. Our superintendent had the coronavirus. Nuestro superintendente tenía la coronavirus. There's people in an administration, en la administración que tenían la coronavirus. Can I tell you, le voy a decir algo. They're already out, ya salieron. They're already home, ya están en la casa. Why? It may have touched their body, but it couldn't stay there. Tocó su cuerpo, pero no podía quedarse aquí. I tell you, it may touch your body, but it will not stay in your body. It has no authority in your body. Your body is temple of the Holy Spirit. Tu cuerpo es templo del Espíritu Santo. Puede que la enfermedad te toque. It might touch you, but it will not stay. Nothing, nothing that is not of God can stay inside of you. Nada que lo que no es de Dios puede quedarse. I don't know. Somebody wants to shout to God right now. Alguien que adore al Señor ahora mismo, ahí mismo donde está. David gets out. David sale and he says, who is this Philistine? Who is this uncircumcised, ugly looking giant? ¿Quién es este filisteo feo que no vale nada que está haciendo esto? May I tell you that cell, you can't even see it. That virus, you need a microscope to see it. Tú necesitas un microscopio para verlo. And yet that little tiny insignificant thing has the world trembling. Tiene el mundo entero temblando. Ese insignificado virus. Now I need you to understand. You cannot be looking at the giant. You have to look at the God that rules over the giant. Tú no puedes mirar al gigante. Tú tienes que mirar al Dios que es sobre el gigante. You're going to have to start changing the way your eyes see. Tú tienes que empezar a cambiar la manera que tus ojos ven. And change the way your ears hear. Cambia la manera que tus oídos oye. Listen, I realized like never before, me he dado cuenta como nunca antes, that people lack so much faith. No tenemos fe. We talk about faith. Hablamos de fe. We say, I got faith. Yo tengo fe to be healed, para ser sanado, to be freed, para ser libertado. But the reality is just a religious statement. Es solamente algo religioso. Because in order for you to be able to be a person of faith, para que tú seas una persona de fe, you need to get in the middle of the arena. Tú tienes que meterte en medio de la arena, en medio donde está la guerra, and where the war is at. You can't go and be in the palace. Tú no puedes estar en el palacio talking about faith to your people, hablando de fe a tu pueblo. No, you got to get in the midst of the situation. Tienes que meterte en medio de la situación, and be able to look at the situation, mirar la situación, by faith. faith, por fe. You either believe God or you don't believe God. O le crees a Dios o no le crees a Dios. David said, I'm going to bring this giant down. Yo voy a tumbar a este gigante. This giant is going down. Este gigante va a caer. And guess what everybody told him? Todo el mundo le dijo, shut up, shut up, shut up. Cállate, cállate, cállate. Tú eres un niño. You're just a child. Who are you? You're not even ready. You have not, he said, you think I'm not ready? I got ready when the problem wasn't here. Oh my God, I'm going to tell you something. Yo me preparé cuando no estaba el problema. See, the problem is you only get ready when the problem comes. Tú preparas cuando el problema viene. No, before the problem came, before the giant came, antes del gigante venir, David was already saying, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Jehová es mi pastor, nada me faltará. He didn't start quoting the word when the devil was hitting him. He quoted the word when everything didn't seem to be perfectly right. Cuando todo se veía bien. See, you need to show up when nobody's watching. Tú tienes que aparecer cuando nadie está velando. When nobody's watching, can you worship God right now that nobody's watching you in your house? Cuando nadie te está velando en tu casa, puede adorar a Dios. Because the devil understands people who are afraid. You know who the people who are afraid are? Those are the people that when the problem comes, then they start praying.
Esas son la gente que tiene miedo, que oran por el problema. Cuando viene el problema es que empieza a orar.
The devil's afraid of those people that when there is no problem, they're already binding him. They're already attacking him.
El diablo le tiene miedo a esa gente que cuando están solos. See, David did it when nobody was watching him in the fields, cuando él estaba en la finca, watching over the sheep, velando las ovejas, when there was nobody there, cuando no había nadie ahí, when he didn't have nobody patting him in the back. Wow, you're a great preacher, you're a great poet, you're a great singer, tú eres un gran predicador, un gran poeta, un gran cantante. When nobody was watching, he was doing it by himself. He understood what it was to encourage himself. Él sabía lo que era animarse mismo when nobody was watching, cuando nadie estaba velando. He knew how to sing a good song, right? When he was alone, cuando estaba solo, él sabía cantar un cántico nuevo a Jehová. He knew how to sing a new song unto the Lord. He knew how to, the Bible said that David would get up and he would dance. 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 We even sing it. We want to dance like David danced. David se paraba y danzaba. Could you dance when everything is going wrong? ¿Puedes tú pararte y danzar cuando todo se está yendo mal? Watch this. I'm going to bring this 1 Samuel 17:45. 1 Samuel 17:45. Dice, entonces dijo David al filisteo, tú vienes contra mí con espada y lanza y jabalina, pero yo voy contra ti en el nombre de Jehová de los ejércitos, el Dios de los escuadrones de Israel, a quien tú has provocado. David said to the Philistine, you come against me with a sword and a spear and a javelin. But I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of the Israel whom you have defied. Now watch this. Watch this, because you're using the wrong tools to fight this battle. Tú estás usando lo que no debes usar para pelear esta batalla. Oh, I know. I'm already getting calls. Pastor, ya estoy recibiendo llamado, pastor. I can't take it anymore. My husband and I are always fighting. Mi esposo y yo estamos peleando. The kids are driving me crazy. Los nenes me están volviendo loco. You know who I'm talking about there. You're out there right now listening. Tú estás escuchando. But I'm going to tell you something. Your problem is that you're trying to do everything in the flesh. Tú estás tratando de hacer todo en la carne. And that does not work like that. Así no trabaja esto. This defeat will not come. Esta derrota no va a venir in the flesh. En la carne no va a venir esta derrota. This defeat will not come in your flesh. Hear me, church. Escúchame, iglesia. My friend that is listening to me, mis amigos que me están escuchando en todas partes del mundo, in every part of the world, esta derrota viene. The devil can only be defeated through the power of the Holy Spirit, a través del poder del Espíritu Santo. You need to understand that David said, I know I can't beat you the way you want to fight me. Oh, you didn't hear this. David dijo, yo sé que yo no te puedo ganar como tú quieres pelearme. No, no. I understand that you look bigger than me. Tú te ves más grande que yo. How many of you know this problem looks bigger than us? Este problema se ve más grande que nosotros. In fact, it's confounded the science. Ha confundido la ciencia. It's confounded doctors. Ha confundido doctores. Leaders and presidents and prime ministers are confused. Los presidentes, todo el mundo está confundido. Because can I tell you, David said, I will not, I know I can't beat you. Yo sé que no te puedo ganar. I understand this. I understand that if I get in your territory, si yo me meto en tu territorio, you're going to beat me. Tú me vas a ganar. But I'm not fighting in your territory. Yo no voy a pelear en tu territorio. There's a new fight. Hay una nueva batalla. There's a new fight that's come to this camp. Hay una nueva batalla que ha venido a este campamento. You've been playing your little games in your area. Tú estás jugando tus juegos allá. You've been scared. Scaring the people, asustando a la gente. But I'm going to tell you, I know, I see your spear. Yo veo tu espada. I see the people that are dying. Lots of people are dying. I see your javelin. Yo veo tu javelina and how it could destroy and kill and people. Como puede destruir la gente. I know that this virus is doing a lot of things. Yo sé que este virus está haciendo muchas cosas. But I want to look at the virus not from the territory of the virus. Yo no quiero mirar a este virus del territorio de esta influencia. Yo no quiero mirar la influencia del lado de la influencia, no. I want to look at it from the side of God. Yo lo quiero mirar del lado de Dios. Sí, the virus is over there. El virus está por allá. But I'm here. Yo estoy aquí. Where am I? I am seated in high places with Christ Jesus. Estoy sentado en lugares celestiales con Cristo Jesús. Come on, people. Does not the word of God say that? No lo dice la palabra de Dios que estamos sentados con Cristo, juntamente con Cristo. We're sitting next to Christ. If you're sitting next to Christ, if he is with you, who can be against you? Si él está contigo, ¿quién puede estar contra de ti? You're sitting. Are you or not sitting? Listen, I know you who are there right now. You're doubting, está dudando. You're listening to me, me está escuchando, and you're doubting the word of God. But listen, Juan, you can doubt the word of God. You can doubt the word of God. Every time you doubt the word of God, you are fighting this fight in the territory of the enemy. Ya cada vez que tú dudas, está peleando esta batalla en el territorio del enemigo. I am challenging you today. Te estoy retando hoy to fight the fight like David. Pelea la batalla como David la peleó. David, look at the giant from far away, lo miró de lejos, and he started sizing him, lo empezó a mirar, and the Bible says, había dicho, listen, it's what you know how to do best. I don't know what you know how to do best, no sé lo que tú sabes hacer bien, but in the spiritual realm, en el cielo, en esta área del cielo, en esta área de espiritual, if you have learned how to pick up the right stones, si tú has aprendido a tomar las piedras perfecta. You know, five stones, cinco piedras. He took five of them out. Cinco. You know why? Because that giant had another four brothers. Porque ese gigante tenía otros cuatro hermanos. You didn't know that, right? Tú no sabía eso. And just in case he went down and the other ones came, he said, I'm gonna bring him down and I'll bring his brothers down too. Tumba a él y lo va a tumbar los hermanos también. And so he goes down on the river and he picks up five stones, smooth stones. Cogió cinco piedras que eran bien livianas, bien, estaban bien preparadas, redonditas. And he put them in his pocket. Lo puso en el, oh my God, oh, this is powerful. Lo puso en el bolsillo de él. Let me tell you something. You always better be prepared with spares. You always better have some spare prayers, some spare fasting, some spare reading the word. Tú tienes que tenerle en tu bolsillo oración, ayuno, leer la palabra. Póntelo en el bolsillo. Put it in your pocket. Because you may knock one giant today. Puede que tú tumbes un gigante hoy. But there's more that are coming. Hay más que viene. Listen, just because you serve God, porque tú sirves a Dios, does not mean that the devil's not going to attack you. No quiere decir que el enemigo no te va a atacar. But if you're prepared, si tú estás preparado, it ain't nothing, no hay nada que el enemigo traiga contra de ti, that the enemy brings against you, that you will not be able to knock that giant down, que tú no puedas tumbar ese gigante. So I tell you, church, rise. Levántate, iglesia, levántate. Watch what he does. He puts it in his pocket and he looks at him from far away, and the virus was looking at him from far away. And yes, because that giant was a virus. Ese gigante era un virus. Y de lejos lo miraba. He said, you ain't nothing. You're nothing for me. Tú no eres nada para mí. And David said, go ahead, keep on talking. He said, you see how big I am. Tú ves que grande yo soy. Que grande yo soy. Y tú eres chiquito. You're small. And look how big I am. And David's looking at him. The bigger they are, the harder they fall. Mientras más grandes son, más caen al piso. So get ready, giant, because you're coming down. And if you call your brothers, they're coming down too. Because the devil knows he's coming down. And if every demon in hell wants to come against you, they're going down too. Why? Because the glory of God is upon you, porque la gloria de Dios está dentro de ti. And the Bible says that when the giant got ready to hit him,
David put a smooth stone. David puso la piedra on his slingshot. Y lo puso la onda. And he just said, I come to you in the name of who? In the name of who? In the name of the mighty Lord. Vengo en el nombre del Dios grande y viviente. And he's moving. See, if you're going to move, move in the name of the Lord. Si te vas a mover, muévete en el nombre del Señor. Move in the name of the Lord. Muévete en el nombre de Dios. If you're going to go shopping, si vaya a comprar, whatever you go to get your food, don't go in there scared. No vaya ahí con miedo. Go in the name of the Lord. Use your protection if you have to. Usa la protección si tiene que usarla. But go in the name of the Lord. Fear not. Because the Bible says that when he let go of that stone, cuando dejó esa piedra salir, it said that it hit the giant, tumbó al gigante. And guess what? Mira lo que hace. David brings that giant down. And when David brings the giant down, all of Israel, todo Israel, cuando David tumba el gigante, todo Israel se levanta. All of Israel starts glorifying the name of God. Empieza a glorificar el nombre de Dios. Why? Because I'm telling you, church, there is coming a day. Viene un día. This giant is coming down. Este gigante va para el piso. We're going to come into this house. Vamos a venir a esta casa. Dancing, shouting, praising God, just worshiping the Lord. Every church, cada iglesia will be celebrating. Va a estar celebrando. Why? Because the giant is coming down. El gigante va a caer. I need you to hear this. I'm going to finish with this because this is a prophetic word God gave to my life. Esto es una palabra profética que Dios me dio a mi Dios. He said, get up and make your own news. Levántate y haz tu propia noticia. Stop letting the newscasters make your news. Watch, he said. It says, fear has gripped us in such a way that we can't function. El miedo nos ha tomado que no podemos funcionar. And are hiding in our spiritual cocoons. Y estamos escondidos en nuestros lugares espirituales. Believing and trusting God and hoping in God, but not having faith. Creyendo y confiando en el Señor, pero no teniendo fe. The mayor of New York said, he will close every church. El alcalde de Nueva York dijo, cerraré todas las iglesias. And we will close them permanently if I have to. Y la cerraremos permanente si tengo que hacerlo. That is a lie of the devil. Es una mentira del diablo. But let me tell you what the Lord says. What does the world think? Who do the world think they're dealing with? ¿Con quién se cree el mundo que está bregando? And what fear has gripped the church? ¿Qué miedo ha tomado la iglesia? That we do not know how to stand up to the very creatures and human beings. Que no sabemos cómo levantarnos contra las criaturas, los humanos. That God created. God himself created. And are being manipulated by Satan. Están siendo manipulados por Satanás. Look what the Lord told me. He told me, write this down. Who does a mere man think he is to talk to the church, the body of Christ, that way? ¿Quién se cree el hombre que es hablarle a la iglesia así? Who does that man think he is saying that he's going to close up the church permanently? He's coming down. He says, does he not know, no conocer, that my word says, que mi palabra dice, that the gates of hell, que la puerta del infierno, shall not prevail against the church, no prevalecerán con la iglesia. Does the world not know, no conocer, and realize that the church has risen up from the ashes? No conoce el mundo que la iglesia se ha levantado de la ceniza. Watch this. That if Emperor Nero, si el Emperor Nero, through, he tried to kill and burn them alive. Trató de matarlo y quemarlos vivos. And had animals devour them, los animales los devoramos. Then persecuted the church, persiguió la iglesia. And stated, y dijo, we have destroyed the church, hemos destruido la iglesia. But in her infancy, cuando estaba esperando, cuando todavía era niño, watch what it said. It was him who died. Fue él que murió. It was the Roman Empire that fell. Fue el Imperio Romano que fue destruido. And from the ashes, de la ceniza, the church rose. La iglesia se levantó like an eagle, como un eagle, to become a powerful church, para ser una iglesia poderosa. Watch what it says. Does not the world not know? Does the world not know? No sabe el mundo. Not that the church flourishes in the middle of persecution. Que la iglesia crece en medio de la persecución. That you can burn it, close the buildings down, but the church is mighty. It is not a building. Que tú puedes quemar la iglesia, puedes cerrarla, pero la iglesia es poderosa. La iglesia no es un edificio.
It is the most beautiful body of all of redeemers. Es la, el cuerpo más precioso de todos los redimidos. Washed by the blood of the Lamb, lavado por la sangre de Cristo. Around the world, we are all together. Alrededor del mundo estamos juntos. We will rise up again. Nos levantaremos otra vez. With a louder voice, con una voz más, más grande. With a stronger song, con un cántico más grande. We will rise up with a bigger dance. Nos levantaremos con una danza más grande. If the God that we serve, si el Dios que nosotros servimos pudo hacer en el Viejo Testamento, in the Old Testament, he was able to part the sea, pudo dividir el mar. He was able to get Joshua to stop the sun. Josué paró el sol. If the God that we serve gave the people manna, si el Dios que servimos le dio al pueblo manna, how when we will never suffer of hunger. Nunca sufriremos de hambre. Because the Lord God is watching over us. If in the New Testament, Nuevo Testamento, he opened the eyes of the blind, abrió los ojos de los ciegos, raised the dead, levantó a los muertos, multiplied the bread and the fish, multiplicó los panes y los peces, walked on water, andó sobre las aguas, told Lazarus, come forth, le dijo a Lázaro, sal fuera. If he died and rose from the dead, si él murió y se levantó de los muertos, if he was resurrected, si fue resucitado, and filled us with the Holy Ghost, nos llenó del Espíritu Santo. What authority do we really have? ¿Qué autoridad verdaderamente tenemos? But church, it's time for this generation. Iglesia, es tiempo que esta generación to get up in the name of Jesus, se levante en el nombre de Jesús, and start writing their own legacy. Y escribamos nuestra nueva legacia. Could it be that all this that is happening, puede ser que todo que esto está pasando, is God preparing us to write our own legacy, que nosotros podamos escribir nuestra propia legacia? Could it be that God is getting you ready to write a new book? Tú vas a escribir un nuevo libro. Could it be that God is preparing us? Puede ser que Dios nos está preparando to rise, que nos levantemos. Rise, church, rise, levántate. It could it be that this time period you're home, God is preparing you to be a poet. Dios te está preparando a ser un poeta. God is preparing you to be a songwriter. Dios te está preparando para que escribas canciones. It could be that in this time, en este tiempo, that you're home, que tú estás en la casa, God is preparing you to be a mighty warrior. Dios te está preparando para que sea un gran guerrero. It's this time, es este momento, when the enemy has come against you, cuando el enemigo ha venido contra ti, that you're picking up what you know how to do the best. It could be that you stopped singing in church, dejaste de cantar en la iglesia. You haven't done any worshiping in a long time. No ha hecho adoración en mucho tiempo. It could be you have not spoken to a sinner in a long time. No ha habido un pecador en mucho tiempo. But God is rising you. Dios te está levantando so that you may speak to the sinner, para que le hable el pecador. It could be this time, este es el tiempo, that your daughter and your son who are lost, que tu hija y tu hijo que están perdidos, will come to hear the word of God, vienen a oír la palabra de Dios, and their lives will be changed, y su vida serán cambiado. It could be, puede ser, that as we rise as a church, como levantamos como iglesia, that every giant, que cada gigante, who will rise up against you, que se levante contra ti, will fall, caiga, if only you will believe. Si tú puedes creer, all things are possible. Todo es posible to him who believes. Aquel que cree. If you believe with me, si tú crees conmigo, I want you to do one thing. Yo quiero que tú hagas una cosa. I want you to get up. Yo quiero que tú levantes. Right there in your house, ahí mismo en tu casa. I want you to get up. I want you to get up. Right there. Because the Bible says, la Biblia dice, that Jesus, Jesús, got up, se levantó. And this is our church text. Este es el texto de nuestra iglesia. And the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. El Espíritu de Dios está sobre mí. Because the Lord has anointed me, porque Jehová me ha ungido, to preach good tidings to the poor, para predicarle nuevas a los pobres. He has sent me to heal the sick. Me ha mandado a sanar los enfermos. To heal the brokenhearted, para sanar los que están heridos de corazón. To proclaim liberty to the captives, para proclamar libertad a los cautivos. And open the prisons to those who are bound, y para abrir las prisiones a aquellos que están atados. So right now I'm believing. Ahora mismo estoy creyendo that there is something supernatural happening. Que algo supernatural está pasando. Si tú crees que algo supernatural está pasando, if you believe that something supernatural is happening, if you believe, I want you to look at that virus right now. Yo quiero que tú mires ese virus ahora mismo. I want you to close your eyes and I want you to see it in your head. Quiero que tú lo veas en tu cabeza. As this giant, este gigante,
who is trying to defy the armies of the Lord,
que está tratando de defadir los ejércitos de Jehová. Él está tratando de mirar a los ejércitos de Jehová.
He's trying to look at the church. Está mirando la iglesia. I got you in your houses. Los tengo en la casa.
You can't go to church. No puede ir a la iglesia.
This may be the first time.
Puede ser que esta sea la primera vez.
Your first Palm Sunday. Tu primer semana de este tiempo que tenemos. Que tú no has ido a la iglesia. That you have not gone to church. Because to me, para mí, I'm here, estoy aquí. But I'm preaching, estoy predicando to my church, a mi iglesia that's listening, que está escuchando. So it's almost like I'm there with you, estoy allá con ustedes. But I want you to think, esta semana de Palma, this weekend of Palm Sunday, the world, el mundo entero, would be celebrating, estaban celebrando, as they bring palms to church, trayendo palmas a la iglesia. And we celebrate Christ's entrance into Jerusalem. Y celebramos la entrada de Cristo a Jerusalén. How painful it is for you right now. ¿Cuánto te duele ahora mismo that you can't be here with us? Que no puedes estar aquí con nosotros. It's difficult. It's difficult. And next Sunday, el domingo, is Easter Sunday. Resurrection Day, Día de Resurrección. And it's going to be tough if we can't be here.
Va a ser difícil si no podemos estar aquí.
But may I tell you something? You are going to do something supernatural. Tú vas a hacer algo supernatural. Right there where you're at, ahí donde tú estás. I want you to lift up your hands. Tell your children to lift both hands up. A los niños que levanten las manos. All the kids out there, all you kids out there, please lift up your hands. Levanten sus manos. Because I've been teaching you that this is the year of two palms. Este es el año de dos palmas. 20 means in the Hebrew. 20 significa en hebreo. La palma, the palms of your hands. But 2020 means two palms. 20 significa dos palmas. This is the year when you will not raise just one hand. Este es el año donde tú no vas a levantar más que una mano. You will raise both hands. Levantará las dos manos. You will worship God with both hands.
Levantará tu mano, adorará con Dios con todas las dos manos.
Come on, get out of that seat. You've been sitting on it for 2 weeks in a row. Just get up and give God at least this moment.
Dale este momento a Dios.
I can see people spiritually in my mind. I can see people still sitting. I can't believe you're still sitting. Why don't you get up in the name of Jesus? Lift your hands up everywhere, everywhere. Could you imagine right now if all of us who are watching, todo lo que están velando, would make this prayer, hagamos esta oración. The Bible says if two of us would get into one mind, whatever we ask of the Father shall be done. Si dos nos pusiéramos de la misma mente, lo que le pidiéramos al Padre será hecho. So we're going to lift up our hands together. If you're sitting down and you get sick, don't call me up. Si estás sentado y te enferma, no me llame. Don't call me, Pastor, pray for me. No, because you were disobedient. Fuiste desobediente. Get up and be obedient in the name of Jesus.
Levántate obediente en el nombre de Jesús.
Don't care where you're at. No me importa donde tú estás. Rise, lift up your hands. So raise your hands. Rise, church. Rise, church. Rise, church. Lift up your hands. And you're going to say with me, te va a decir conmigo, God, Señor, I come before you right now. Vengo delante de ti ahora mismo. God, Señor, this giant, este gigante, called the coronavirus, llamado el virus corona, has no power over me. No tiene poder sobre mí. It has no power over my children. No tiene poder sobre mis hijos. It has no power over my family. No tiene poder sobre mi familia. God, I come together with all my brothers that have their hands lifted. Señor, vengo junto a todos mis hermanos que tienen sus manos levantadas. Right now, in the office where Jackie is, hands lifted up, la mano levantada. Right now, everybody with hands lifted up. And you're going to say right now, in the name of Jesus, say with me, in the name of Jesus, en el nombre de Jesús, diga conmigo, en el nombre de Jesús, I bind you sickness, te ato enfermedad, I bind you spirit of death, te ato espíritu de muerte, Jesus came to give me life. Jesús vino a darme vida. And give me life in abundance. Y darme vida en abundancia. Tell him you will not touch anything that is mine. Tú no tocarás nada lo que es mío. Not my children, not my family, not my house, not my car, not my finances, ni mis hijos, ni mi esposo, ni mi esposa, ni mi finanza, ni mi vehículo, ni mi casa. Everything I have, keep your hands out. I come against you, vengo contra ti. In the name, en el nombre, that is above all name, que sobre todo nombre. In the name of Jesus, en el nombre de Jesús. Tell him, I come to you in the name of Jesus. Vengo contra ti en el nombre de Jesús. And I tell you, y te digo, that you are down in the name of Jesus. Caerás en el nombre de Jesús. Right now, just start praising God. Praising God right there, just hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can hear the thousands of voices right now. I can hear them in my mind. Voices in all these houses right now. As you worship. Yeah, that's right. I am imperfect. But God is perfect. Right there. We thank you, God. Listen, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, si no conoces a Cristo como tu Salvador personal, I want you to tell him right now. Yo quiero que tú le digas ahora mismo, Jesus, Jesús, forgive me of all my sins. Perdóname de todos mis pecados. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb. Lávame la sangre del Cordero. Write my book. Write my name in the book of life. Escribe mi nombre en el libro de la vida. If you said that prayer, si dijiste esa oración, welcome to the family of Jesus. Bienvenido a la familia de Cristo. Church, now you can take your hands and put it this way. Put them up because you praise God with them. Now get ready to receive. Now get ready to receive. Prepárate para recibir. Put both hands. Don't receive with one hand. Receive with both hands right now. Recibe con las dos manos. Father, I come right now. Padre, vengo ahora mismo. And I command blessings. Mando bendiciones. Powerful blessings. Bendiciones poderosas. To fall in the hands of your people. Que caiga sobre las manos de tu pueblo. I command in the name of Jesus. Digo en el nombre de Jesús. That all possibilities. Que todas las posibilidades of heaven. Del cielo. Will be upon your children. Que estén sobre tus hijos. I command right now in the name of Jesus. Digo en el nombre de Jesús. Right now, God. Financial blessings. Bendiciones financieras sobre tu pueblo. Financial blessings upon your people. They will lack nothing. No tendrán falta de nada. You will give your people in abundance. Se dará tu pueblo en abundancia. And there will be peace in your the houses of your people. Y habrá paz en las casas de tu pueblo. And your people shall be mighty. Y tu pueblo será gigantesco y grande. Your people shall be a mighty people. Tu pueblo será un pueblo poderoso. They will walk like mighty people. They will talk like mighty people. They will live like mighty people. Hablarán como gente poderosa. Hablarán como gente grande. Hablarán como gente que tiene la unción del Espíritu Santo sobre ellos. God, and I command an anointing this week upon them. Una unción sobre ellos. Like they've never seen before. Como nunca han visto antes. I command this in Jesus' name. Now I need you to say right now. Necesito que tú digas, I receive it. Recibo esto. Say it right now. Tell your kids. Kids, come on. All you kids out there. Say, I receive it. I receive the blessing. Recibo la bendición. La recibo. Thank you for coming. Thank you for hearing us. Thank you for listening. Oh, my God. I feel an anointing here right now. Ah. Oh, there's such an anointing. Hay una unción grande aquí ahora mismo. I don't know how God uses me. No sé cómo Dios me usa. I don't know why he uses such a a person with so many flaws, una persona con tanta falta. But he does, he does, he does, he does. And he uses you with all your flaws. He was like, oh my God, there's an anointing in this place. I praise you, God. I praise you, God. I know I gotta leave you. I know I have to leave you. Don't get hello. But I love you. I love you, church. I love you. I love you. I miss you. Me hacen falta, iglesia. Le amo. Your pastors love you. Su pastor le ama. We love you. We love you. I love you. I miss you. I miss you. I want to hug you. I want to hold you. I want to kiss you. Quiero aguantarlo. Quiero besarlo. I just want to look in your eyes like we did every Sunday evening as you were leaving. I looked into your eyes and told you, I love you so much. I miss you. I really do. But I know we will be together soon. Estaremos juntos. To all of you who have been giving, thank you for giving. Todos que están dando gracias por dar. Please don't stop giving. No paren de dar. Please. We're meeting our bills, and thank God for that. For you, for every one of you. Please go online, All the Nations, HE. We have a new webpage, and in that webpage, you go down on giving, and you will find all the vehicles to give. And if you want to mail it to 660 Landis Avenue, Bristol, New Jersey, 08320, something like that. You'll see the address. So please mail it out to us. I love you. I love you. I love you. Could you tell me I love you from where you're at? Get a big hug. Tell me I love you. 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 God bless you. God be with you.